My name is Michael Parks. I play for All Them Witches and on IndieBuddy.com. I grew up in Louisiana. I moved all over the country. Moved to Nashville when I was 19 and started meeting these guys. And we just kind of met like how people meet just at work and at bars and shows and whatever. But yeah, it's just been a really good fit ever since then. It's hard to imagine playing music with other people after playing music with these guys. So I don't think I want to change that for a while. I feel like the concept for the albums have all been the same. It took me a little while to realize it. It's like you have a draw to say certain things and to make certain music, but maybe you don't always understand exactly why you're drawn to do it. So Sleeping Through the War is more just my take on current events, current time, a couple of different storylines like weaving through there, and it's hard to say because everybody has an equal say, like input into the band, and I feel like the musicians are, or the instruments are also speaking. It may sound cheesy to say that, but I feel like they're also telling a story. It's very dialogue based kind of music, and so yeah, I would say that Sleeping's just another take on where we are in our lives and how everything is affecting us. Yeah, Alabaster. I think that's my favorite, just because live, I get to yell and dance, I think it's my favorite song that we've written so far. No, I don't think we did it consciously, but I think about that a lot because I get asked that a lot. When you're younger and you're so hungry to find new music, especially if you move to a new city, like none of us are from Nashville. When you move to a music city like that, it's just shows all the time, all week long. You can go to a show every night at any venue you want in Nashville. And so I was hungry to discover new music, because where I grew up in Louisiana and New Mexico, there wasn't like a big music scene. But after playing with these guys and being on the road so much, and I spend all of my time with them, like two-thirds of the year, like we're on the road, and so this is my home, and we make music together, so we don't seek out new music as much. So I think that that's just like a general evolution from being like, well, did you hear this band? Well, I really like what they did, and like, let's, you know, try something like this. And then now it's just subconscious, like how we write music and how it happens. So yeah, I would hope that we can't be categorized anymore. I'm looking for that. I don't want to be in anybody's box. Yeah, I don't know why we chose him. I mean, I don't actually know how, because he wanted to do Dying Surfer. Like, he wanted to do the album previous to this one. And I just don't think that we were ready to let it go from our own, like, DIY kind of thing. So he was the first real, like, big-time producer we've worked with. I think we're just, you know, willing to give it a shot. And the next album's going to be different. We probably won't do that or look for anybody bigger. We're just going to try something new. So, yeah, I like Dave. I honestly had not heard much of his catalog, because, I don't know, I just didn't know it. I didn't know how famous he was until, like, one day he had to leave our session to go to, like, an awards show that he was, like, getting the best award or something. He's just a really awesome guy, and he loves music, and he loves, like, producing music and making music, so it was easy to work with him. I can't expect anything from anybody, because like, I don't know how our stuff is going to turn out every night. I don't put any expectations on ourselves or on our fans, so I can't do it for any of the crew or engineers. I like everybody to feel like they can just be themselves, and that's what Dave did. We fought just like on one song, but not for very long. You know, we worked it out, so that was good. A lot of give and take. I appreciate that in a person. No, I don't think it's difficult. I think that if you grow up knowing that mentality, just like where blues music comes from, where I grew up and where Ben grew up in Florida, he was like a surfer, or like he is a surfer, but like he kind of grew up in the whole surf thing, but also where he grew up in Florida is like Allman Brothers, you know, and so that was like a big part of him. And a lot of those like good Florida blues bands and southern bands, and then I just grew up in like the heart of it, really, like in the Louisiana scene. and heard what my dad listened to, and I don't know, blues music is just, it's just honest, like, it's honest, it's the guy sitting there and singing about what's troubling him, and yeah, I think that if you're not singing about the things that affect you in everyday life, then you're not really being honest or genuine about it. So yeah, the blues just comes out because you feel blue, you know, it just happens. So yeah, you don't learn anything if somebody just gives it to you, right? Teach a man to fish, I believe in that. But yeah, that's just how I interpret it, I guess. Like, I can't sing about getting drunk every night or like chasing girls or doing whatever. So yeah, that's a hard one to, I don't intentionally do it. That's just like the words that feel good coming out of my mouth. It's like, that's what goes on the page. So yeah, it's a very basic kind of broad thing, and then you wheel it down. So, and as, like I said, that kind of happens, and then later on they develop more meanings for me as it, and like the meaning changes as time goes on, and I appreciate that. I think that our albums can kind of be chopped up, and you can make sense of them with any of the songs, just putting throughout the years. Sorry for the rambling. There's too many songs about that, and it's not interesting, because it's like, that's like a very surface, kind of superfluous lifestyle, and not that I should, I can't knock that, but that's not what I want to sing about. That's what most pop country bands sing about, so, and we're definitely not that. Yeah, absolutely. Especially the new one, because we had like backup singers and like a mellotron and some instrumentation that we won't bring out live, and so you have to work it with what you have. And what we have is four guys and just like aggression, I guess. And so it just comes out as four guys and aggression. And the jamming stuff is all, I think that's all the substance. Like, everybody can have 5, 6, 7 different melodies for one song, but you can't put that all on the record track, right? So live, it's very different. You can change up whatever and how you're feeling. So yeah, I would say that live, a big change, and one that I like better. So yeah, live is where we feel most at home. No, Robbie did, our drummer. He does all of the artwork and has done all of the artwork except for the first album. So, it was released through a German label, and they had an artist do it. So, but yeah, ever since then, it's all just been Robbie. And I don't know why he did it. It's a lot like music. His approach to art and photography is a lot like our combined approach to music, which is experiment until you find what you like. And usually that's going to be a lot more gratifying than like hammering out something in your mind that you want exactly. It's like, you can, the universe provides kind of mentality, I guess. Yeah. That hurts. it's a painful lifestyle. It's also strange. It's like you come back to your house, but your house looks different every day, like this. Like, this is what my house looks like today. And then the van is another coffin-style house, and then the plane is also your house. And, yeah, touring, a lot of people just, like, think bands and touring is just nothing but party, and that couldn't be further from the truth. For us, at least, it's, like, work. It's honest work, and, but I love it. I've been doing it for 10 years, and I love being on the road. I also like going home now because it's quiet. I don't live in the city. It's so different. Like, I live out in the country and there's nobody around, and then it's just city after city after city, like different country, different language, different currency, different everything every day, and you can never adapt, and you can never like feel completely at home anywhere. But that drives the music too. So just the constant change is really good for me. Yeah, it's like every day there's a bizarre experience. and then like trying to recall them is really strange. It's hard to remember where they happened. I remember a lot from the early days, back when you have a little more time to explore cities and get into trouble. But now it's like you see a couple of blocks around the venue and have to get in the bus and drive somewhere at night. And so I saw a fight last night. I was hiding in the van because everybody went to the bar, and our van has tinted windows, so like you never know if anybody's in there. So I was sitting in the van, just minding my own business, and then this fire erupts from the bar next door in Manchester, and just a bunch of howdy. Yeah, just a bunch of testosterone flying around, and that's always really funny to watch. So, yeah, that's the most recent one for me. I don't know, I just walked down the street, tried to go to the music store, but it was closed. And then I came back, and we just did sound check, and now you're here. That's my whole Irish experience. Yeah, we're driving to Belfast tonight, and then we get on the ferry in the morning to go to Scotland. It's always such a, the look on people's faces when I tell them that is so sad, because it's like everywhere, they want you to explore their city, and they want you to be, like, feel welcome and stuff, but I just have no time to do that. So, can barely catch a language, you know, and bits and pieces of German and French and whatever, and then you're back in the UK and you don't need it anymore. It's hard. But the ferry ride was good. You got to see the cliffs. Got to ride the ferry. And that's it. That's all I got. Not exactly. The shows are earlier here, and in Europe, I would say that they're earlier, which makes people, I think, happier to like come out to a show. They can just go home and be with their families and stuff, instead of like an American show where it's the headliner starts at midnight. Don't get done until 2, which is terrible. But no, like, as far as, I don't know, just like a general personality, I think that everybody's, the more I travel around the world, the more everybody seems to kind of get homogenized. So, not in a bad way, but yeah, like the people are all, they're all good. Yeah, I like them all. Fans. I'm actually really proud of our fan demographic because it's like little kids, old, all the way to old, like every kind of race and creed and like upbringing. And I really appreciate everybody coming out. I'd say that half is planned and half is not planned. So we have a couple of 18-minute songs, you know, 15, 18-minute songs. Yeah, that takes up a lot of the set when you get into it. So, yeah, I'd say half and half, which is how we do our albums too, about half written and half made up. Yeah, don't start a band. Don't be in a band. No, I mean, if you're willing to like be honest about it, and you're not just trying to like rip somebody off or just like art should be for art's sake, and you should feel happy with the music that you make, but you also shouldn't take yourself too seriously. I think that's where a lot of bands break up. It's like you get to a certain point and everybody's blowing smoke up your ass, and then you just get like a big head, and then it just goes downhill from there. So other than don't be in a band, if you do be in a band, do it with every fiber of your being. Yeah. Scotland. And then we get back, we have some more in Europe, and then we go back to the States, and then we have another tour, and then I think we have the winter off, which is crazy. We never get more than a couple of weeks off. I think we have 3 months off coming up, which will be really nice. Get to enjoy the winter, maybe go home and see family. So yeah, tour is next, then a break, and then more tour. Yeah, thanks for watching my interview on anybody.